everybody, welcome to a live DIY video here at Home Talk. My name's Julie and I'm a craft and DIY blogger over at Julie Measures, and I'm really excited today to show you some upcycled crafts that are perfect for springtime. I'm here in the North Texas Dallas area, and we're already having lots of spring thunderstorms. We had a lovely tornado watch warning the other night. It woke everybody up, and anyway. So I've got all my rain gear out, and some of it from year to year gets worn out. So rather than throwing it away, I've come up with some fun crafts to use those items and kind of repurpose them and give them a new life. So today we're going to be crafting with rain boots and an umbrella and a garden hose. So those are our kind of the starting point for all of our crafts today. So it's kind of a spring showers theme. As you're tuning in, I'd love to know where you're from, kind of what the weather's like where you are. And of course we have a giveaway going on during the video today. So let me know what your favorite spring activities are. Here in Texas, we're big on blue bonnets and taking blue bonnet pictures. It's kind of a tradition that we do. So let me know what the spring traditions are, where you are, what your favorite activities are. Do you like to go to art shows, craft shows? What's going on? Okay, so I'm gonna start with my rain boots. And I've kind of got a couple ideas for these. So sometimes rain boots, so I love my rain boots, but they can look, you know, sometimes they're just a little bland or they look like everybody else's. So the first thing I wanted to show you was just a really easy way to personalize your rain boots and make sure that you're never going to get them mixed up with somebody else's. There's a couple ways you can do this. If you have a vinyl cutter, you can just cut out the letters. You can also, I just went to the craft store and I bought these vinyl letters, and when you peel them off, I picked these gold ones. I really like gold. And when you peel them off, they are clear. I'm ripping up the page with it on this one. They're clear. So when you put them on, there you go, you can kind of see they're see-through. So that when you put them on the boot, you just see the clear part or the gold part, and it doesn't, you know, the letters look really nice. So I don't know about you, but here in Dallas, monogramming is a big thing. All my girlfriends love to have all their stuff monogrammed. Towels, your handbag. If you can put a monogram on it, you should put a monogram on it. So we're going to put a monogram on our boots. So I'm just going to do my initials. And it's funny because, well, I say all my girlfriends love monograms. I don't do as much. Not that I don't like it, but I don't have as many things monogrammed. So I actually had to call my sister and I was like, wait, which order do they go in? And after laughing at me a little bit, she told me. So I'm going to do these on the outside of the boot so that when you're walking around, everybody can see them. So I've got my last name initial that'll go in the center. And you can see that's nice and see-through on that vinyl sticker. And then you just get the gold letter coming through. So these stickers were fun because they came in different sizes. There's two different sizes included. So there's the bigger letters that I can do for my last name. And then it had smaller letters that I can do for my first and middle name initials. So if you need a refresher on monograms, that's kind of the order. Last name in the middle, and then your other initials flanking the outside. So there's my J for Julie. And then I will pull up the last letter here and try not to rip my sticker. Of course, if you have a vinyl cutter, You could do these in any color you want to match your boots. But just like that. And it's real simple, and it just gives your boots some fun personalization for the spring. And then you can see I've already done the other side. So there are my cute boots. Now, sometimes your boots get worn out, right? Or you've got kids and you have to buy new ones every year because kids grow and their feet, you know, the ones that they wore last year don't fit this year. So I also wanted to show you with our rain boots, if yours have cracked, if they've worn out, if you just want to buy yourself a new pair because you want a new pair, whatever it is. They make a really fun kind of centerpiece. I would recommend making sure they're nice and clean, because if you're going to put them on a table or something, you know, you don't want them if they're caked in mud and dirty. So I'm using a pool noodle, and I'm going to start by just measuring how tall I need it to be. So I want the pool noodle slightly shorter than where it is inside my boot. So I've already kind of marked a spot, and then I can just use a knife and cut through and, you know, not cut my table. And I'm going to cut a few of these because I'm going to fill up the boot. But this is just, you can use, you know, this styrofoam from the pool noodle. You know, you can grab this for like a dollar at the dollar store or Walmart. So you can just cut those down, and then you can fill up your boot with the pool noodles, and that gives it some shape too. So you can just stuff those down in there. And that one might not want to go all the way down, so I'm going to cut it in half. And there we go. Just give the boot, you know, some shape. And then I've got some silk flowers, and I'm just going to cut, these came all as a bunch, but I'm going to separate them all out. So I'm going to cut one, I've just got some wire cutters, and I'm just cutting down at the bottom each branch. Somehow this, the price tag seems to be attached to my flowers, doesn't want to come off. So just down at the bottom, I'm just snipping off, this is kind of some lilies, but whatever flowers you want. I just got these white ones because I thought it would be fun to match the white on my rain boots. So whatever color matches, whatever looks good at your house, you can grab some silk flowers. You could probably also do this with real flowers. I've only ever done it with the silk flowers, but if you wanted to use, you know, the green floral foam that you get wet and put in there, you could certainly give that a try too. So once I get all these cut, just got a couple more here. And that one does not want to cut off, does it? Okay, so I can just toss this bottom part. And spring is all about the flowers, right? I mentioned that one of our favorite spring traditions is going to take bluebonnet pictures. So you can just add these. And then as you can see, that the foam noodles provide a fun spot where I can poke in all of my flowers, and I can even, you know, push the flower into the foam. Okay, let me show you that. So you can change, you could use it to give you height. You know, I can push it down low, I can keep some of them up higher, but that really lets you have some dimension to your flower arranging. So maybe the ones on the outside I'm going to push down lower, and then the ones on the inside I'll make higher so I can get some height there. And once I've got those all in, it's just a fun little, you know, centerpiece with flowers and gives your, you know, especially if these are boots that are worn out or you can't wear anymore, and if they've got a cute design, it just makes a fun little centerpiece for that.
So. Carol says you could put some stones in the bottom of the boots and then plant live flowers.
You could, yes. Thank you, Carol. So as we mentioned, don't forget that we're doing a giveaway. So as we're going along, let me know what your favorite spring activities are. So there's our boots. I'm just going to kind of put those over here. And then we're going to talk about our garden hose. And you might not have ever thought about crafting with a garden hose before. This is admittedly a very short hose. But if you've got a garden hose that's worn out, that has holes in it, you could certainly cut it down. I do recommend a finished length that is, I think this is about 6 feet. Because of what we're going to do with it, you don't want it to be too heavy. So if you've got a really long garden hose, you could just cut it down. If you've got, this is just a short one, and then it's kind of fun because it's got the fittings on either end. But if you've got a long one and you cut it down, you know, you could splice it so you take both ends and then put it together. But we are actually going to turn this garden hose into a wreath with like 3 supplies. So once you have your garden hose, then you're going to want to take some just zip ties, cable ties.
Shannon says her favorite wreath she ever made was out of a hose with a pair of gardening gloves.
Oh, I saw those. Those are really cute when you add add the gloves. Thank you. And I love because you can add a lot of things to this, or you can keep it pretty simple. I am primarily just sticking with the garden hose, but I'm using the zip ties too. So I'm just going to kind of overlap that part. And then I'm going to zip tie it together and tighten that down. Kind of back and forth. And then I'm going to do another one. And then I'll trim the ends. We had just moved back into our house last year. So we've been pulling out a lot of the things from when we lived in a house before out of storage, and some of the gardening supplies did not last being in storage for 3 years. So it's been fun to take some of the things that we can't use anymore and turn them into something else. Okay, so I've got my garden hose, and that is the foundation for my wreath. And then to decorate it, I've got some more silk flowers, and these I've already snipped. So they came, you know, like the other ones, in a bunch, and I already snipped them down. Now, you could hot glue these on top. I am just going to use the zip ties and pull it down. This was a way that I can reuse these flowers if I want to. Or if you've got a hose that, you know, you want to craft with but might be useful in the future, it's not broken, then you can have fun with that hose and not damage it. So a couple different options. But you could certainly just hot glue these flowers down too, and that would work. Or craft glue or Gorilla glue type stuff. And then with the zip ties, I can kind of just slip my flowers in. And it holds them in place. And I've kind of, let's see if I can. I want this one. to go through the top one and not... Oh, he's getting caught with the other. I see the problem now. Okay. Trying to angle his stem here to twist for me. There we go. I think I got it this time. Okay.
He's trying to go through all of
them. He is. This is my sister Lauren's here. My sister Lauren is here helping me with the video today.
Hi, viewers.
So, it's... She, yeah. Helps with all my crafty adventures. Okay. Somehow I am pulling the top part of this flower apart. There we go. So that's on there. And then you can just kind of stick in this last one. And those look like that. I've lost a few pieces here and there. And then you can take for some of these I pulled off just the flower bit and tucked them in just to kind of cover up those zip ties a little bit.
Sue says she's from Michigan. It's snowing here. Are you sure it's spring?
Yes, I have lived in Texas almost my whole life. I spent one winter in Utah where we got snow. But, yeah, it's warm here. My kids have been wearing shorts to school. It's like 80 degrees. We are fully immersed in
Candace loves in spring. The Hose idea.
So I'm just kind of, I think actually those flowers covered it, but tucking in those little, just the blooms, you know, I was able to cover up the zip ties so you can't even see them. And that gives the little thing here. The viewer who suggested gloves, you can certainly add in like a pair of little gardening gloves to add even more dimension to that. You know, different colored flowers. But just like that, and then you just hang that up, and you could do that as a front door wreath, or just as some decor in your house. Maybe if you've got a gardening shed or something that you want to put that on, that's super easy to get that on there. And with the flowers, it wants to roll over. There we go. If you've seen the videos here before, as I'm tucking these flowers back in, this eggshell craft here is another craft we did on here on Home Talk. So if you have time to go check that one out on Home Talk too, in time for Easter. But our last upcycled project that we're gonna do today is using umbrellas. I go through, I feel like, so many umbrellas, maybe you do too. With kids, I try to have them everywhere. I've got one in each of my cars. I've got some by the front door. My high school student walks to school, so he's got one in his backpack. My elementary student, if I know it's going to rain, I'll stick one in his backpack, because even though he's pretty close to, I drive through and pick him up, you know, just that dash even to the car to make sure he's covered. I keep them by the front door. With so many, there's always one, it seems like, that's breaking, right? Whether it's the metal part that breaks or there gets holes or whatever. It's just, umbrellas seem to be a disposable commodity. So, I've got a couple on hand that are broken that we're going to craft with today. So, this is just kind of the standard fold-up. I'm going to give myself bad luck by opening this in the house, right? Umbrella, but it's got that are too small for you probably to see, but it's got some holes in it. It's worn out, so I need I can't really use it for rain anymore, but I can use it for a centerpiece. So it's, I'm gonna start with it folded up, and then I found a vase that's about the same height. Now, I do want my umbrella to come out a little bit on the top, so I am going to add a few river rocks to the bottom of my vase.
Casey loves the craft kitty on the sofa.
Yes, this is Ranger. If you follow me on Instagram, I showed a picture of him. He was laying on the table earlier while I was getting ready. And he loves when I do these videos because I've got all these lights in here that we turn on and they're nice and warm. And I think he thinks it's like, you know, a cat laying in the sunshine. He comes in and lays on the table because it's warm from all the lights. Okay, so I've got some river rocks in the bottom. And then I can add in my umbrella on top. And that just gives it enough height so that a little bit of the color of the umbrella sticks out. This isn't the cutest umbrella in the world, I know. But if you've got a cute one or if it's got some fun colors, that might be even better. But it's just, it is what it is. So, then I've got some more silk flowers. These are kind of some big ones that I thought were pretty. And most of these I found just at the dollar store. So, then I can just tuck in these flowers into my umbrella. And I might snag some of those white ones out of my boots and show you. But you can just kind of...
Would colored sand use for raising up the umbrella?
Yeah, definitely. I just happen to have a bunch of these river rocks on hand that I've bought for various projects. Okay, I'm stealing the lilies out of the boots. So I can fill this in. So, I just liked because of the color of the umbrella, I liked the white flowers, but I thought it was fun with the two different kinds of flowers, even though it's all the same color, that it still gave it some, I don't know, some texture, some dimension. So, and I wanted the handle of the umbrella to still stick out the top. So you get the color of the umbrella, you get a little bit of the color peeking out at the top of the vase, and then you get the flowers out of the top. And then you get the little handle as kind of the peak of the arrangement. And I just thought that was a really fun way, especially if you have an umbrella that is really cute. I have 3 boys, so I have mostly muted colored looking umbrellas. My teenager, surprisingly enough, doesn't want to walk around with a really cute hot pink umbrella. But you know, whatever you have. This one does match my house a little bit, so it's just a fun way to take something and give it a new life. Now, I know a lot of us probably have these folding umbrellas, but I'm a big fan of these umbrellas too. Now this one, I'm going to give myself more bad luck because I'm opening another umbrella in the house. Part of, you know, rain is all the wind, right? And this one got caught, and you can see right here, is broken because it got flipped inside out. So it doesn't really work so great as an umbrella anymore. But it will make a really cute wreath. So for this one, I've got this this style of an umbrella. And I'm also using some ribbon. So don't forget as we're going along to let me know what your favorite springtime activities are. For that Home Talk tote bag giveaway. I'm really excited. We're starting to have all of the arts festivals are starting, and I love going and seeing all the local artists and what they make. So all of our outdoor shows happen usually April and May around here. Okay, so I am tying my umbrella, and I'm going to wrap this around just to kind of take up
some of the length of this ribbon. And then I'm going to tie just a little bow. It doesn't have to be, you know, perfect. I'm sure there's bow makers out there that could tell me how to tie a really pretty bow. But this one works. There's just some purple ribbon that I found that I thought matched the blues. I really liked the blues in this. I've been kind of on a spring showers kick theme. That was kind of the idea for this too. You know, the hose, the boots, the umbrella, spring showers. So I'm going to, these are not the right scissors for that. Okay, you could trim the edges there. So that keeps this bottom part together. And then we have this part that's open. And I'm going to fill it in with some flowers. And I'm going to kind of take them from that. This time I'm focusing primarily on the front. And I'm going to alternate some of these flowers. So I'm using these real pretty kind of pinkish ones, and then these white ones that are the same bloom, but just in different colors. And get that to go down in there. And then I'm going to go back and stick the opposite color in some of these spots to give it more kind of bulk in the front. All right, so I need another pink one. And another white one. And I've got another pink one here. So I'm gonna add to the center part, and then one more white one. And goes like that. And then this would go on your front door, and you would just use the handle if you have you know, one of the wreath hangers that goes over the door, or you just have a nail on the door, you can hang it. And because we've put all those flowers in front, then it leans forward and then the back stays flat. And then you can just hang that on your door, and it makes a really fun wreath. And we can add a little detail, which I forgot, I had grabbed these. So I found these really cute cardboard tags, and then I've just got a chalk marker, and we'll see if it's gonna write for me. Okay. So for both, either one of these, you can make a little note. So we could write, welcome, or you could do one that says, our theme, our spring showers theme, spring showers. So you can just write those on there. And then I've got a little bit of yarn. If you follow my page over at Julie Measures, you'll know that I'm a knitter and a crocheter. So I always have yarn on hand, lots and lots of yarn. And we can just, so I think the spring showers would be particularly fun with our umbrella. And somehow I have this bow turned around. Okay. So we can just add a little note down here at the bottom. Just give it a little more personalization. And I grabbed this blue yarn because it matches my blue umbrella. I might have cut this string too short. See if I can get it looped around into a knot. There we go. So then that just hangs. If I hold this. And then you got that spring showers note there at the bottom that's super cute. We can take this welcome one and attach it, you know, anywhere on our garden hose wreath. If you missed any of the, I'm going to tie it up here a little bit. You know what? I'm going to need a little bit longer of a piece of yarn. Thankfully, there's no shortage of yarn at my house. Ever. As my sister just smiles, because she knows. There's yarn everywhere. Okay. Then I can just tie this on here. And have a little welcome sign that adds to our garden hose wreath. So if you've missed any of the crafts, we did these monogrammed rain boots, and we used these vinyl stickers that you can get at the craft store. You can also just print your own in whatever color you want. I really liked these gold ones with the clear background, because then once they're on the boot, you just see the letters, and it shows up real nice. Then you'll never get your boots confused with anyone else's, especially if you're taking them off somewhere. So that was kind of, I loved that everything we did today was only a couple supplies. So our boots were just the boots and the letters. If you want to turn it into a centerpiece, we used a foam noodle, and then we stuck some flowers down, and you could do it into the foam, in the middle of the foam, and make, you know, obviously fill it up and make a fun centerpiece with that. Then we did our garden hose wreath, and we used zip ties to pull it together. And then we just tucked in, you can get up close, we tucked in all of the stems on our garden hose into the zip ties, and then we covered it with just a few little flowers. And then we just added that fun little chalkboard sign that says welcome. So we did, so you know, what was that? Two things for the monogram, two more if you make a centerpiece. We've just got about three supplies to turn our garden hose into a wreath. And then we did our two umbrella crafts where we filled the vase, the bottom of the vase, with river rocks. Somebody asked if you could do colored sand or something else in the bottom. Definitely whatever you have that you think would just raise it up enough so that your umbrella just pokes out the top, so you get some of that color and it's not all in the vase. And then add the flowers to decorate it. If you have this style of umbrella, then we just simply tied a ribbon at the bottom. We added a cute little spring showers sign, because it's an umbrella, so we're being a little bit cute. And then we just filled it in with some silk flowers. So if you've got some items at home, some, you know, the accessories or tools for the spring, I hope that this gave you some ideas for how to upcycle those, reuse them, give them a little personality, another use for them. Thanks for sharing all your great ideas for your favorite spring activities.
And Home Talk has chosen a winner.
All right, who's our winner?
Samantha Brownell.
We're sorry if we can't say your name.
Yeah, sorry.
We're trying. congratulations, I'm so glad that you've got a Home Talk tote bag coming for you. I shared that some of my favorite spring activities were going to craft shows. I love seeing what local artists are making, and I love all the wildflowers that we get here in Texas. Don't forget to turn back to Home Talk at 7 p.m. Eastern tonight for another live DIY project. And head over to Julie Measures for some fun projects that I'm sharing there. And I'm looking forward to coming back and crafting with you guys again soon. Have a great day. Bye.